I've known no other world than magic. From a young age, all I experienced was magic. Going to school, I saw magic in everything. I can't imagine not being a magician.
The workshop is where I basically design and create new ideas. And so I've got table saws and skill saws, band saws. I got a laser back here. That's my joy. This is where I thrive.
I think magicians are drawn to playing cards because they're easily accessible. It's the gateway trick to magic. Secondly, the audience accepts it because it's a regular household item that just about everybody has. And what's great about magic and cards together is it elicits an emotion, like you think of Las Vegas when you see a deck of cards. Or maybe you think of a smoky back room where there's a cheat like the Maverick ripping you off, or the Sting where there's an entire con going on. It's been going on forever. Magic and playing cards have this huge relationship, and it's like the universal tool of magic. Now, as a magician, I don't usually look at playing cards. I'm surrounded by them, but I use them as a tool. I don't look at the designs. And now I realize those designs can be inspirational and creative. On a recent tour of France, I took a day's vacation. I went sightseeing to a medieval castle called Chateau en Bois, and there I saw a symbol that I was so familiar, but I couldn't put my finger on it. And then I realized I'd seen it thousands of times. It appears in the King of Hearts. You see, experts will tell you that the cards are named after famous people, like King David, Alexander the Great, and Julius Caesar, and that the King of Hearts is Charlemagne. But what if those experts have it wrong? What if there's a connection between Chateau en Bois and the king with the sword running through his head? And what if that connects us to Charles VIII, a king who mysteriously died at the chateau 500 years ago? I need to return to France. I need to learn more about the history of a deck of cards and the designs and where they came from, because I think hidden in that deck of cards are clues to a 500-year-old cold case murder.